Hello guys, and welcome back to the next rainy episode of Banished with me, Biffa. Thank you very much for joining me. It's just been changing a couple of things before we start diving into the episode. You guys have been letting me know that these dock fisheries can actually take more people than normal. These normal fishing docks take four. When you build these, they only give the option of one through this menu here. But you can change that and add more in, which is what I've done. There's a couple of people saying they're out of work. If we drop this down a couple and put it up, there we go, we'll get four people in here. So it'd be interesting to see how much food they get. So we'll leave them working there. We'll see what happens. We're still trying to work on getting all of our stone production going. Something I do want to add in, which is probably slowing down production at the moment, is a shore house for clay and a shore house for sands. They take one person each. I was going to just add a couple of those in extra if I could, and then we're going to get stuck in to trying to sort out the problem we have with getting lots and lots of stone. I want to turn that this way, so we could squeeze one right in the middle of here, which I think is quite good because we can't fit any houses in there. So let's add one there, and then let's maybe stick one down the side here, so not too far from the paths and things. There we go. And how much stone do we have? We only have 28 stone at the moment, so I'm not making any roads with stone right now. We're doing everything in dirt. So we have a lot of spare labourers, people that can get stuck in and help us with things. We have the hunting cabin I built. Here we go, the Forester's Lodge. So this was new last episode. That will start getting us a lot more stone from this area here. Also, you told me in the comments, so this little dense tree shack will actually get better as time goes on, because he will fill this area up, and because it's a dense tree shack, he will really get a lot of trees in there. So I do sort of have it overlapping, not the barn, not the log cabin, here we go, the Forester's Lodge, a little bit. It comes up to there, yeah, overlaps a little bit. We'll see how it goes. I don't think it's going to affect it too much. But yesterday, we got this going. Look at this. The town hall, so we can really see what we're doing. And this is fantastic for keeping an eye on production. So let's take a look at food. That's the thing I've been worried about the most. We have 115 citizens, so 100 food each. We really need 1,150 food. I think that is correct maths. We have 5,993, so we really could do with making more. Our current production level is 6,000. We've used 8,000. We really are not producing enough food. So more farms, I think, out this way would be good. So let's get as many people as possible working on these farms. I am going to do... Let's have a look. We were getting people collecting stone and things. Yeah, this is still marked. Let's have a look. Oh, it's not marked for collection. It's like little red flowers or something. Let's mark a load of stone for collection. There's like a load here. Let's turn this way. There we go. So if we mark all of this for collection, actually people are going to end up walking miles to do that. Let's build a little bridge so they can get backwards and forwards. We'll just build a cheap wooden bridge. There we go. So they can get across there. Excellent. Oh, the snow is kicking in. I do love a good snow. I do love a good snow. Right, so I'm going to put some more farms in here. Let's get... Nope, that's not what I want to do. I'm going to put this path all the way across to the edge. There we go. And then if we remember rightly, these were all 15 by 8, weren't they? So let's get this filled up. And then I'm going to add... Here we go. And then we're going to get our... Let's just... Double check. 8 by 15. Yep, that's good. We probably don't need houses between every single one, but we may as well. We may as well, just so we can get people not having to travel too far. The town abode was one of these over here. I forget. There's so many houses to choose from. Town abode. There we go. So we'll have that one there. Yep, we'll have that one there. Let's drop these in. Let's speed things up a bit as well. There we go. So 8 by 15. And then we're going for the same behind to really make use of our space. Excellent. 8 by 15. There we go. So let's get those going. So this is corn. That's going to be sorghum. That's sorghum. That's corn. So this will be sorghum. And this one will be corn. And of course, they all need people to work at. There we go. We've got to clear that one out. Excellent. Here comes another trader. There we go. The bridge is done. I'm just wondering whether we could have... Let's see. Oh, also, yes. The pickup. I've got that turned off. I mentioned that briefly last time. There we go. So what you want is the farmers to harvest the food as quickly as they can. There we go. And not worrying about having to run backwards and forwards with it. So they will literally harvest it and leave it on the ground. And then spare labourers... Oh, here we go. Will come along and carry that back to wherever it needs to go. So this barn over here. So that will mean that they can spend as much time as possible harvesting the food, which is what we want. So let's see. What's this guy brought along? Coconut, linseed oil, tinned fruit... Wedding pemmican. What the heck's that? Some sort of wedding cake? I don't know. Tulips and mangoes. Okay, so we're basically... We've got 1,000 items that we can trade. Let's just have a look at our inventory. How many reeds do we actually have altogether? 1,245. So if we do all of those, another 1,000 will immediately, well, you know, slowly be shipped across from there. So we don't want to lose them all. Let's have a quick sip of tea and think about this. What food can we buy? I'm not quite sure with the tulips, whether they're just things that you can stick in the ground. I mean, we don't really need... Linseed oil seems to me like it's something that you can use in something else. I don't know. I'm just wondering, because our food is building up. I'm thinking we're just going to save this for now. Dismiss him and not worry too much about that. We'll leave him. Yeah. And we'll see what he needs at a later time. What are you waiting for? You don't have enough... Yeah, see, this is where things break down. We need more sand. We need more pottery, which means they need more clay. They need more glass. So, yeah. They're going to be working on that. Let's put that one there. Let's put that one there. And also our lumber production. Yeah, they're waiting on... Oh, they've got the lumber. That's fine. Building supplies. He's taking all the lumber. How much lumber do we have? Lumber. Zero lumber. Okay, well, that's good in one way that we're not just running out of... Oh, here we go. So let's have... We're not running out of wood. So we'll have that one as sand. Yep. And we'll have this one as clay. Once it's done... did we not put in another... Oh, we didn't put in another place to worship, did we? We were thinking of building the great big church in here. I wanted to do some planning out in here. Let's... Because we've got some... Let's just pause this a second. We've got some nice city roads in here, which look good. What do they take? They take stone and stuff, which we don't have any of. So I'll tell you what we're going to do. Is I'm going to mark things out with a dirt road for now. Let's place like a dirt road down there. And our city walls can sort of build up here. We can place them down, can't we? And then we can pause them so they're not built. So maybe we'll get an idea of what's going on. Okay, so just looking through the pieces here. I like these corner pieces. What I'm thinking of doing is building out, because obviously we're right by it. That bridge will go eventually, but if we can go sort of out like that and then build along here, we'll sort of see how that works. It'll be interesting to do. That's going to take 10 steps. Yeah, we can start getting some of these done. So if we go like that and then rotate that one round like that, so that'll just take 10 stone and 10 stone. And then from there, we might sort of go straight for a little bit and have like an inner courtyard sort of thing going along. That is a straight piece. What's this one here? Medieval wall filler. Oh, I see. A very small piece. So then what we can do is... If we go this way... And that should line up there and there. There and there. And maybe build some sort of inner courtyard here. I don't know how this is going to go. Let's see. We still have lots of stone collection going on. Wood stockpile, stone stockpile. What's the matter with you? Oh, you're saying you've got all the herbs in the world. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to get you to make even more herbs because more... Oh, there's the stone stockpile. Excellent. Oh, you're putting all sorts of things on there. Let's get this shore house done over here. So that one was sand. This one is going to be clay. There we go. Add you on there. Excellent. Our wood production is going up, which is good. So it really is just stone at the moment. That is the main thing. Stone and food. These are going to be worked now for a whole year. So let's see where these guys live. So this house isn't finished yet, but you're all basically living nearby, which is fantastic. So you don't have to walk too far. How's this doing here? 87%. Let's see. So 100 stone is really bad, isn't it? We really need to see if we can upgrade that. What do we need? Upgrade from surface mine for significant more resource production. So candles. So where are we going to get... Where are we going to get candles from? Let's have a look in here. Resource production. Right, so we have the candlery. Used to make candles out of beeswax, whale blubber, or tallow. So it's looking like we're going to have to build something with bees, which I haven't done for a while. Bees is going to be... Let's have a look. Bees is going to be apiary. Produces honey or beeswax. So that's what we're going to have to do. Let's find a nice little spot for them that's going to be sort of close together without taking up tons of space. Do you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to pause this a second, and I am going to turn off the weather because we are getting a lot of weather, aren't we? Show weather effects. And most of it seems to be rain. There we go. It's sometimes it's nice. But other times, it's very off-putting with what you're doing. So, let's go to here. You got any other options? New food gatherer. Bee shelter. Randomly produces honey. Comb honey and royal jelly. Employs one keeper. Another bee shelter. What's the difference between that one and that one? Nothing by the look of it. Medieval apiary. Keep bees and generate honey. But this one says it does beeswax, which is what we want. I want to keep that for farms. So let's see if we can squeeze them both in here. I think that'd be fantastic. Okay, let's just run our path. Yeah, you can join all the way up there. Excellent. Then we'll grab the... It was this one, wasn't it? Grab the apiary. That is a nice looking build, and I like that one. We did have a path that was running through there, but that path seems to have sort of gone. I'm going to change that around so it goes this way. Yeah, there we go. So we'll have that there. There we go, the apiary. And then the candlery. Let's add that in. That's going to be this one here. And that can go next to it. Yeah, we'll just leave. Where's the edge of that one? That one goes to there. We'll line that one up there as well. Good, good. That's going to take 40 lumber. Good grief. How's our lumber production going? Zero. Most of it is being used for these houses. They've all been finished. Oh, there we go. These guys are working away here. Excellent. Let's speed you up. How's our... Oh, excellent. Our castle walls are going in. Nice. Look at that. That is exactly what I wanted. I want it to go round the corner like that. And then have another gate at this side. I'm wondering whether there's any parts that we can add. Medieval moats. Ooh. Interesting. Well, we'll get to that another time. Sort of armaments that you don't... Well, a watchtower will protect your town, serve as a storage place, and let citizens pass as well. Whoa. Look at that. Now, I like that. If we had one of those each side in the middle... I think that would be fantastic, wouldn't it? And then we can do something in here. Okay, let's build... Let's build this down a little bit more each side. One, two... Like that. Where's the middle? The middle's about here. So maybe we're going to like use up all of our stone. Stone supplies are low. Reserve of iron is low. Okay. Well, we've got people... collecting and making. I've got loads of iron over here. Let's collect a bit more. Stone and iron. Let's try that again. There we go. Mark all that for collection. Mark that for collection. There's loads. Don't be lazy. Go out and get it. Grab it. It's probably... How are these guys doing up here? Yeah, they're still working up here. Okay, that's fine. Food I'm still worried about, but let's see how it goes. Okay, how are these things going over here? They're being built. Apiary's being built first, which is fine. We can start collecting the beeswax that we need. Very good. Enjoying my tea today. That was very tasty. Excellent. So let's get somebody working there. That's this one. Oh, it doesn't actually... I thought it gave you the choice of what it was going to get. It looks like it just gets both. Misread that then. It says there... Produces honey as a food item or beeswax. But it's not actually giving me the choice. I'm assuming it's going to give me some of each. Let's put that guy down there. And we'll see about that. How's our college going? Zero students in the college. That's a shame. What I don't want to do is kick these guys out and have them... These 10 be uneducated. But that village school could go at some point. Because we have this other one here. At least we have the space if we need it. Anyway. Okay, so how's this going here? Small town tailor. We were going to upgrade you, weren't we? Let's have a look. Stone is low. Okay, yeah, that's fine. Well, they're still collecting it, so let's not worry too much about that. So what have we got here? Old tailor house. Tailor. So that's the normal tailor that we've seen before. Let's just go over here where we can see it. But what other options do we have? We have a medieval tailor, which is what we want to go for. Tailoring company, advanced clothing types, small town tailor. I think that's the one we built. Yeah. A seamstress. Now let's go for the medieval. Oh, people are dying, but they're doing okay. The medieval tailor. Yeah, that's good. And we want to get rid of that tailor in there. Oh, we've got another trader. But that medieval tailor, he would fit nicely on the corner here. That'll be good. We'll see what you've got in a second. Oh, you've got Frisian cows. No room for cows. Thank you. Thank you anyway. Okay, let's have that here. Might just run that path around. Yeah, connect that up to there. Excellent. So then we can get rid of that other tailor we've got over here. Oh, the candlery's done. Excellent. So, you are going to make for us beeswax and honey from the apiary. Excellent. Candles from beeswax. There we go. Perfect. Good. We'll shut those two down. So, how many do we need to upgrade this? 70 candles. So, that is probably going to take a while, but that's fine. Let's leave that going. The tailor's going. The wall's going. Oh, I'm loving this. This is looking fantastic. Let's get rid of those trees in there. In fact, let's get rid of everything in there. So then we can put our two big towers. We've got 49 stone. Food's picking up. Food is picking up. I'm thinking another couple of houses here and fill up the rest of these with farm. There we go. Look, so you can see the farmers... They've harvested everything, so they've got it all in before the winter's here, and now the labourers will pick it up. That food will not deteriorate left on there. So, to me, that seems the best way of doing it. So you're not... it's here somewhere. So you're not worrying about not getting your harvest in quick enough. Okay, let's do that. We've got somebody else coming in. Okay, still... Tools, steak, grapefruit, mutton cuts, iron ore, bedding. What have we got? Iron, we don't have much. Do we actually have much iron ore? Is it the fact that he can't work at it quick enough? We've got so much iron ore. So basically, he just can't work at it quick enough. Fine, okay. Guava flour, cauliflower. I'm wondering whether we could just get a load of food just to... Just to sort of maybe help out a little bit. There we go. Thank you very much. So we'll take that. You can leave. Thank you kindly. Let's have a look here then. Let's... Oh, we're going to just quickly put some more farms in. Let's do that first. Before we forget. Yep. Crop fields. I keep thinking it should say farm. That's what it is. 8 by 15. 8 by 15. Perfect. There we go. I'm just wondering whether, instead of two more houses here, we just put some more farms in, because we have two more houses. How wide are they? One, two, three wide. We're going to go one, two, three wide. The fourth one, we'll fit one there. Oh, yeah, go on. Let's stick with the plan. We're not going to fit another farm in there, so we'll leave that bit. Okay, good. Oop. They've got to be finished. Okay, that's fine. What are you complaining about? Pottery. Yeah, we're working on that. Small town tailor. Oh, is the other medieval tailor? He's still being worked on. Good. Oh, the shrine. Oh, the school is full. Students are now going over here. Fine. That's good. I'm happy with that. Let's deal with the worshipping. Worship and remembrance. Let's have a look at this big church. Where is it? Central Church. No, that wasn't the one, was it? This one. I'm thinking... I don't know. It seems to me like that should go inside. Hmm. Maybe I'll come back to that. Okay, let's get this guy working here. Hide coats, leather. Let's just have a look what we've got. What have we got? So leather, we've got 60. We are using our reeds. 6 reed, 3 feathers. Feathers, we have tons. Reeds, we have tons as well. I think we're going to stick with that. Reeds and feathers. There we go. I'm going to up that to 100. 100. Yep. And then we're going to get rid of this little one here. You are going to become unemployed. We just don't need you anymore. So thank you very much. And we'll drop that down. There we go. You're working away. Excellent. We can actually upgrade that. I didn't realise. Medieval tailor makes clothes for your citizens. So it's upgrading to the same thing. I'm not entirely sure. But he's working anyway. Where is it? This one here. Good. Well, we'll see about upgrading that later when we need to. Oh, good. Here we go. So we've got... sorghum corn, that'll be sorghum. Somebody else working there. Excellent, we'll come back to the other ones. Right, let's put... oh, the food's going up nicely. Just what we want. Let's put the two massive towers. This one here. What I'm going to do is stick that out a bit, I think. I think I want that facing... let's see. So the door's sort of on a corner. I'm going to go there, like that. Sort of on the angle. Does that line up right? I'll go in one. It sort of makes it look a bit weird, doesn't it, with the wall, the way the... But if I do that, yeah, it doesn't overlap. And then can I place another? Actually, yeah, because I can't butt it up. Oh, I can. It will overlap. It will overlap and put. Oh, there's a door. Look, I've just seen that. Excellent. So I can get in at the top. That's what I want. That's what I want. I think actually we'll line it up with this one here, and then the door will poke out of the corner. So how's that going to work? Yeah, we'll go with it lined up with this one here. In one like that, I think that'll work. And then I'll figure out when, once it's built, what we're going to do there. We'll wait for that one to be finished. And then we'll see what that one looks like. Hey, something I've just noticed is my guys are running out of fuel. There is no fuel up here, which is a bit of a bummer. So I'm just wondering whether We need to add like another woodcutter in or something like that. That's going to, let's see, not that one, I don't think. No, this one here. Here we go. To see if we can help with that. No, it's not that one at all. Here we go. I wonder whether to go for this stacks burner instead. He says, layers, wood or coal is stacked together in piles and burned into fuel from the inside out. A good source of light fuel for heating homes. So if we put... But these guys having to travel a long way down there. We could have another wood collection area here. I think that would be a good idea. So if we stuck... Let's see. This guy here. We can add more homes in there if we need to. And then we can have another bridge going across here. There we go. We'll go with a wooden bridge as we've been using. Let's have you there. And then over here, we're definitely going to have... There we go. Another Forester's Lodge. Because we really are getting short on... yeah, let's go there. We really are getting short on wood, so we need to make sure that that is definitely taken care of. Got 778, but we're using so much of it. Okay, we're almost there for this tower. Let's speed this up. Get this tower done. Oh, I've got the game paused. That probably wouldn't help. Let's see what this looks like. Okay, here we go. The watchtower's finished. That looks quite good to me. I like that. I'm wondering whether... I don't know. It seems to me that that door has to be on the inside. That you wouldn't want it on the outside. You want to be able to just get in here. But let's see how another piece is going to line up. By the way, we've got a load of nomads requesting access. We have 11,000 food. Let's just quickly look at those. We have... Let's have a look. 133 citizens. So we're not... I don't think we've got enough food. I could do with more food, but... We are starting to run out of people. Not run out of people. We haven't got a huge amount. So I'm probably going to take those nomads once I've figured out what we're going to do here. So I'm just wondering if we grab... Here we go. So if we grab another piece of straight wall and put it there, it's going to block this door down the bottom. But if we leave it... Yeah, I'm wondering whether I should just move that over a little bit. Let's try one on the other side. Let's see. I might just fiddle around with this for a sec. Okay, I've accepted the nomads. We need to get this thing finished over here to give them somewhere to work. There we go. Let's join that up there. Then we've got the Forester's Lodge over here. And then we're going to build some houses up here. That'll be good as well. What I'm deciding to do on this castle wall here... that's not right, what I've done there. Is I'm going to... Oh, we've got a trader. I'm going to build a couple of walls and then build it on the outside... I'll show you in a second. You'll see what I mean. Wow. Mussels, coffee, rope, linseed oil, coconut, pork cuts, coffee beans, oat cookies, military supplies, seedlings, rug, bronze tools, some sort of coats, mulberries, peppers. Wow. This guy has got like the... He's got like a Doctor Who boat. It's bigger on the inside than the outside. I'm just wondering whether we... I mean, coffee beans would be good. I'm assuming we could just go and plant those. Or, no, I bet... Ah, no, I bet that's not the seeds. Whoa, what's going on there? Yellow fever has occurred. Mr. General Trader, you're going to have to wait. Who has got the yellow fever? Santine, the trader. Okay, we do have a mini hospital. He's already... He's the patient. Okay. He's got to walk there, but he's going to pass other people on the way. I don't know how many patients this can hold, but it's only mini. Please do not pass it to anybody else on the way, Santine. Here he goes, here he goes. Just checking it is a he. He's there. And Gemalia is going to fix him up. I'm hoping that's it. It looks like it. Let's keep that hospital open. We only have one patient who's ill. Two people without tools. Oh, my goodness. We're suddenly getting a bit of a problem here. So I'll tell you what, guys. We'll cut that one there. We'll come back in the next episode to deal with those, to check out our towers. Basically, the upshot of what I'm going for, I'll quickly show you with the towers, is theme set, castle, castle walls, towers, is I'm going to put it so it's on the side like that. So the door is on the outside. Where's the door? There we go. So the door is on the outside, but it's down below where you can't see it. There we go, like that. But then there's a door connection onto a tower. You'll see anyway. We'll get to that, but hopefully we're dealing with this yellow fever. We'll find out. No! Somebody else has got it, and it wasn't even nearby. Methridium. Oh, good grief. Okay, right, guys. I'll see you tomorrow. Hit the big B with a tea stain. Thank you for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.